graduation portrait wedding day, and I have it here on the computer in full size of 12 by 16, the canvases, and I have a copy of just the people here, so that if I need a little bit of information, I don't have it, I can measure off of this and get an accurate rendition of it using the proportional dividers, which is really helpful for something like this. So if I measure off the dress from here to the top of the head, that's what it is. So it's pretty close. So that'll really help keep the detail correct. What I'm going to do now is mix up some colors. I have some grays mixed up from a previous painting. I just took all the scrap paint, put it in two piles, and saved it. Looks like there's some greens in here. So because I do landscapes mostly, I have some greens I can use. And some of this foliage does have some of those, does use something like this, this green not so much, but we'll see what we can do. Just took my paints out of the freezer. They need a couple minutes to dry, thaw out, but it seems to work all right. What we're going to do is go to this top foliage in this area, and do some mixing of those darks in that area. I'm using ultramarine blue and burnt umber, and they're pretty dark. I'm putting up against the screen here. Notice that they're at least that dark. And so yeah, so they are pretty much that dark. So I'm going to put those darks in right now, and we'll we're using a medium small brush right now because they're just a rough in. So it's still a number, it's probably still a flat six. I believe it's a six, I'm not sure. So I'm just going to put some of that in, just to start this off. Use a little bit of terps on this. It's almost, it looks like, possibly looks like a dark of a black, but it isn't. I think I'm taking some sap green along with that and just pulling in there as well. And I'm going to key that. What I'm going to do is take some sap green, and I'm going to mix some of this gray green with it. use that for putting in some of this stuff right here. It looks like it should be it's warmer than that, so I'm going to come over here, use some of this, add just a little bit of yellow into that and warm it up just a little bit. Okay, so I'm going to put this down in here. There's a couple of large sky holes I'm going to leave and work around it. So I think a little bit more warmer in this area right here. So going by this is full screen 12 by 16 on here, so I can move it down and up as I want. These were the registration marks I put in for transferring up as tight as I could, so I make sure that this is the same size, can be the same size as that. And it's very close, but it's not exact. But sometimes things aren't exact in painting. Gotta go with it. So we're going right for it right away, sort of all the prima in some ways. Like some of those. Leaves come right down to that, his head there. I'm using some of that green that was waste green from that previous painting. I was given like 1.5 weeks or right, well, just now, December 13th to finish it for Christmas. This is something that probably shouldn't even do. Let's go down a little bit and see how that works. Oh yeah. Okay, so right here is a little dark. And there's some more darks right in here going up. And it's fairly dark all the way up here. Thank you. going to move it up a little bit more. I see some greens down here. They're actually fairly close to this green that's previously mixed up here, so I'm going to use that. Going to dry brush on top of this where the sun is overtaking the leaves, because I don't want to get too detailed or any of that kind of stuff in that area. So this is where that little bit of red is. I'm just going to throw this little bit of red in there so I can identify that placement. This is a little bit bluer into this area. And so I'll put a little bit of that in there. Then we've got a little bit of blue, blue-green back there, but it's tending to be more like this. It's a little bit lighter because it's further away from us, so we'll put that in right in this area. As you can see, I'm still using a pretty big brush for this. Yeah. Alright. A bit more blue or green back there too. So. As well as over in this area. We'll just put this down there for right now. This is dark, a much darker. Add some more ultramarine blue to this existing color that I've got pre-mixed up, and put some of that. Darken it up right down here. And we can go darker yet. So I'm going to throw some down here. Yeah. little bit of burnt umber to this ultramarine blue and put some more. Just trying to get sort of the values halfway, pretty much right in that area right away. Of course, it's a little darker right in here then at the bottom of that. And I see some darkness over here, but it seems to be warm, so I add a little bit of burnt umber, more burnt umber to it, and place that. It looks like there's some foliage there that's kind of in the brownish blue, and we'll add a little bit more right in there. There we go. Bring that down here. And then it warms up back here quite a bit, quite a bit. And so I'm putting some of that down here. In fact, it's very warm. Let's paint, get that. It's like an orange-yellow, a yellow-orange, I should say. But it's pretty light because of the light has permeated it pretty good. It's also reduced. I'm going to add a little cerulean blue and a little bit of Alizarin Crimson to that just to take it down. The thing is, I added too much red and so on, so I add a little bit more yellow again. And I want to bring it down a little bit, so probably okay as long as I add some white to this reduced. Yeah, it should have a little bit more. A little bit more yellow and a little bit more white in it. And definitely more white. Bring it over here. Yeah. All right. So put a little bit of that in here. Dab of something there, and it's on the outskirts here of this green that you have these colors going into the brilliance of light here at this corner. Yeah, so it does infiltrate this area. It's more bluer on this side than it is this because the light's coming from that side. So I'm putting a little bit into this area anyway. Pull this up a little bit more to see this area. Okay. I'm just doing a kind of a dry brush over that. I can see that some of it's there. Pull this down here again and notice that there's some purples back here. This is a much lighter green. That's sort of much lighter green right in here. And in here, it's actually pretty much pretty light. So we add some white to that. And let's get a little bit of purple going. Okay, so we got this purple back in this area. Hope you can see that. This is kind of covering up that little bit of area there. Okay, so we'll just leave that there for right now. Okay, now we're going to pan back. And look at the whole thing again. All right, so see definitely that a lot more darks up here. So I'm going brushing according to how the tree and the leaves are growing in that direction. See if you're still with me here. Yes. 4 minutes left. There's a pretty good dark right here, so I'm going to put that in so I don't lose track of that. So easy to do that sometimes. And there's a dark above his head right there. I'm going to put that in right now. I'm not going to... Then there's this dark here coming down here, and then it goes up. Okay. What we're going to do, I think, just to get things rolling here, we're going to mix some his suit up. That is a real, that's a gray-brown, a brown-gray, I should say. I'm going to use ultramarine, burnt umber. I'm going to use some of this yellow ochre type mix here. And this appears to be better bring this. Yeah, it's still all lower keyed. It's not quite that yellow, a little bit bluer. I'm gonna add a little bit of cerulean to that. Not too much. Okay, I overdid it, so I'm going to mix some more. Burnt umber. It's like a green yellow. Okay. I think you can see everything pretty good. So we're going to leave it right there. I think I'm hoping I'm not really going to be in the way much. You can probably see my profile. That's too bad. But it's very hard to get to exactly the right place. Very hard to put up tripods and so on in the correct spot. It's tough. Just one of those things. Okay. I'm going to take some of this and we're going to add some more burnt umber. Definitely some ultramarine blue. We're going to make up his suit color, and it's pretty good. It disappears. So let's put that on. This color right in here can be the little bit of light that's shining onto his because of the light shining on here. That's a little bit of profile edging of light on along his person here. So I'm gonna just take a little bit of terps and we're gonna fill in this area. But you can't understand what's really happening right down there with his shoe. So we're just gonna let that ride. And pull this down here. It appears like it just kind of falls off. And I'm just going to smoosh this together right here. And we're continuing on here. I wasn't going to accept this commission because there's no time to really get it done, but I noticed when I looked at the reference photo that they wanted to use, I noticed that it was almost all in profile and is in subdued light so much that it was going to be very beneficial to me completing it fairly fast. So I took it. Throw some of this green, brownish green in here because it's coming back and we're seeing a little bit of that, which is sort of reflection off all the greenness around here onto his kind of greening. Making his suit coat and everything lean towards greenish side in the shadow areas. using more of that greenish mixture that most people would have thrown it away from that last painting. Here I found out it's just what I need over here. Okay, his hand is the rest is there now, and I notice that this is it's amazing when you look at this, you think, this is a lot bigger. This image is a lot bigger than this one, and it really isn't. He's got hair that almost emulates the same color as the suit. So I'm continuing on here. I have some yellow ochre sort of mixed up here, and I'm looking at it and I'm thinking that face with a little bit or just a little bit of touch of red in it would be almost that color, and so I'm going to put that in, including his ear, which is a little bit lighter, but I'll just include this here. There. I know it's him because they can see more of her. There is a off to the left. Off to the left of his foot here, right in here, there is a throwing down bouquet, and that's in the dark. That's in the dark here, but it has a little bit of red in it. We'll just hint at that for right now. And leave it. Take some of the sap green and so on, and we'll just allow it to rest there for a little bit. So it looks like here. I like this two hash marks for his feet. I think that's gonna work almost in this painting without doing much to it. Sometimes suggestion is 9/10 of a fight. Okay, we're going to throw in a bunch of sap green in this area. It's close. A little bit of burnt umber into it. And I'm going to cover this area up. From her feet, there's a shadow cast here, and that comes down here, and this comes down. So, also from that area, it appears like there's a, it's make up a blue green. It's fairly dark in here. This is coming down back here. I think this is kind of a shadow of her dress, her being right here as well, but it's all in shadow. That, you can't really tell. I'm throwing in some lighter greens right in here. More yellow greens right in here. For right now, I see some yellow greens up here. Her dress is here. I have to watch out. Her foot kind of explodes forward and wraps around here. That's about the right green, not too far off. There. I happen to know the bride here, not the groom very good, but the bride, very beautiful, and a very good accomplished actress. She's really fantastic. And the singer too, of course. Okay. Gonna add a little bit of yellow to this area right in here. And I don't really see her foot. I actually think her other leg is behind hers right here, doing some kind of a circular move. There. So now we're going to cut across around here, and let's do a little green. Are you still with me here? I guess. I have the camera set so you can take in all of this, but maybe it's too much. Maybe you can't see anything because of it. I have no idea. I want some comments back and say, hey, could you do this and that, or we could ignore that, and whatever you want to do. It would probably be helpful to really know, because I have not done a lot of videotaping and so on. So I'm all learning everything. This is definitely bluer back there. I'm going to add some just looking at it, I'd say no, it's not that blue green. But I use an implement or something. This tracker, I call it a tracker, guys. And by golly, I'm off. I don't know why I could be off so far, but I am. Okay, I've got to go a little bit warmer in here. A little bit warmer. So let's see what that looks like. And also I have to look for the, you know, make sure that the value is right. So let's look for the value. Oh, it's almost right on. Need to go just a little bit more yellow right here. And that's the color that I'm going to use right here. All right, we're back again. Batteries were exhausted, so takes his lithium batteries, and so every time they go, which is often, that's 10 to 12 bucks right there, or more. Four of them. All righty then. I just got done mixing this green, if you remember, and putting it in. Anytime you add white, that actually is bluing it a little bit. So you try to cut down on the white as much as possible. If you can mix it from other colors, that's better. I add a little bit too dark, this mixture. It's generally the same color, but you know, the value, same value all the way through here. So I'll just put it down here for right now. The same. This green in here, in between his. Okay, I'm gonna continue this green over here. It's pretty much the same thing. And we might as well continue that over this way too. It tends to be a little bit yellower here. Warmer, much warmer, and this is sort of the same. So we're put this in here like this. Pulling some of this up with some burnt umber here, and this is a little bit darker in this area, so we'll allow that this to come up a little bit. This is furly. Got some warmth in this area. It's actually a little bit lighter too. This is this sort of a white purple. It's something between a purple and a green. How can that be? It's more purple than anything. But I'm gonna warm it up a little bit. And putting that right in here. It's a little bit up here, a little bit. There. Spot right. For right now. So I see more of a blue-green right in here again, and just touch that up a little. It's got some warmth on it. Okay, so it won't be too long and I'll be getting rid of this large brush. I'm going to hit this light, the lights here a little bit. Now, see if you're still with me. Okay. That is like, you'd think that is white, but it isn't. Very near white, but I never really like to use white in any painting. So we have to pull back. I have to change some of the other things to make that look that much brighter, because I don't have anything brighter than white to use on this light area. So let's say I like to add just a little bit of yellow to white, very little bit of a lot of yellow, and I call that my lightest light. That's in this painting, and it's right above her head, right in this area. So I'm going to have to put that in. Now I gotta, actually this brush is a little bit dirty, so I have to change it out. It's a little bit green. I'm getting some green, a greenish tinge to it. So, and the part of the reason for that somewhat is that white is a blue, does blue to some extent. So let's put that in. And I'll be adding probably more texture right in here later, because I like to add the most texture in the lightest area at times. That does not change much throughout this area, so. Very light areas in here too. Like the dark and the sky holds this a little bit into those areas that are further up. The smaller the sky holds. Trouble is, you've got to center on three or four or five larger sky holes and then cut down on all those little ones. There's tons of them here. Tons. And it's very easy to overdo them. So that's what we're gonna do, is underwhelm sky holes. We have to, okay, there's one up here. There's many of them here, but you have to kind of group them. So in no place where do I really have it as white as the canvas. Gotta cut that back because it's not gonna work for you otherwise. You're not given light like that computer. So I can't match some of those lights. I'm not gonna try. There's some leaves almost right in his forehead here. I'm gonna get rid of those. Don't want too much of that in their face. I do have a few of them there. They're very light. Because, you know, they're just, don't want to overdo that. I don't want to worry about those right now. Just trying to block this in. Now let's look at smaller brush. I And we're going to look at her face right now. He's got a couple highlights on his forehead here, but I'm not going to get too much involved with that right now. Also, I think we overdid this. His nose for right the time being, but we'll just not worry about that too much right now. Checking the her hair color. Checking out her hair color here. I have to go back to my implement here. Oh my gosh. Definitely have to darken it. Sometimes you hold your you think that it'd be pretty close to just hold your brush with paint on it up to it, you know, but that just doesn't do it. It's not as accurate. All right, I'm just gonna put that in and she has a tiara on, but we'll worry about that later too. The Beauty and the Beast here. Right at the moment, anyway. Then her skin color, which is a very subdued flesh color, very subdued, adding a little bit of red to this yellow ochre here that I've got, and yet it's, you know, not only subdued, but it's also in shadow to some extent. So what color is that? Very difficult to analyze. I think I've got it here though. We'll just put this up here and see how close it is. Oh my gosh, it's almost right on. Okay. So let's put this in. This is so small. Even this brush seems very big for it. a string of pearls on and a whole bit. So they're going to be fun to do. Adding a little bit of dark to this back side of the hair here. Adding a little bit more red to this area of face, and so, have to be careful there. All right, so this dress is something else. So in shadow as well, it's probably a chiffon or what I know about this. But anyway, what it is clean this out right here. All right, let's look at the general tonality of this dress. Whoops. I came up too fast on it. Okay. I'm not going by this. Okay, here we are back. I mixed up a gray and we're filling that in right in here. And in this dress here. It's actually kind of sort of a red-gray right now. And then I'm going to put has a little bit of orange on this area, and white. Thank you. some of these greens into from this area and meet up to that dress here, and then from this area to meet up to the dress. Just putting a little bit of yellow ochre right in here. It's not really yellow ochre, I mixed it. It looks like yellow ochre. Okay. And I'm gonna add a little bit of yellow, some of this mixture. It looks, appears to be a yellow ochre into this area because it's not exactly that color. It's got some of this yellow ochre. It's picking up some light and, you know, from that area. And it's very slight, but it's there. Oops. So, trying to get rid of some of the canvas here. I get canvas all over this place. So, just get rid of this. Make sure that you get rid of all the canvas. Then you can worry about the, you know, it's very important to get the edges right, but everything is at its time. His nose is not quite that big. So let's take that off. Let's reduce that nose. I want to look at his face. And they see that. Better. It's got a pretty prominent chin, but it's not that prominent. There we go. Better, better, better. Now that collar is white, but it's certainly not white here. It has a red purple, reddish purple tinge. And but still is white. I mean it appears to be white, but I'm going to pull that down. Try a little bit of green in that to soften it. It's not that not that red either. So I'm gonna put that in. I watch it. You get one thing out of proportion, everything's out of proportion. His hair on the top side is reflecting a lot of light up there. And the only way I can tell, I can get that to appear like it is here, is I'll put some of those doggone leaves in the back of it. So I'm going to do it. I'm kind of pushed into doing that. To put them in exactly the same spot, but I want to get it so that highlight on the hair stands out. So I don't want to cut across his face as it does here. So, trying to look at that, at her face a little bit more, and it's dark. Okay, and her, his hand, foot is very much darker. Let's just put that in. It's definitely darker. I have to switch to a smaller brush. Some of this area now. See some darker greens along here now and judge how dark those are. Thank you. So we're essentially trying to get rid of all the canvas. So I'll allow you to look into this process, because although it's kind of boring at times, you can see that when it gets boring for you and so on, that's out of character. There's some oranges in here, and I'm putting some of those back in. I can see some, I'm going to put some reds up here, some Alizarin Crimson, and some of that, some of the Ultramarine, and then some of the Burnt Umber and so on, to bring these out. I don't know, I see. Now this is not normal. I mean, you can mix it up exactly, and then it will take you, you know, if you want to put 100 hours into this thing, that's fine, but I tend to want to get going on it. So I trust my instincts at times too. And so I'm using Ultramarine Blue on this. Maybe I should be looking at this reference instead of this reference. I gotta watch it. Make sure you're looking at the same reference all the time. Oh, whoa. Okay. People find painting painting folds complicated, but it's pretty much like doing anything else. I have to get this twist right. Comes over here. It comes all the way crossed. Way over here. My gosh. Gotta get that right. There's a little bit of peach in there. So we'll put some of something like that in there. I don't know if it's peach or reddish. It's peach. Kind of put a little bit of that in there. And let's see, but that's sort of like right here at the edge. To every fold there is a shadow side, and shadow side is not going to be that dark. It's a little bit blue. It's a little, there's some yellow ochres as well in here, and I'll put them in. I get placement of those in the right place as well. Otherwise you can really lose out. So you have as an impressionist, you're getting a lot of different colors in here, but if you were to just try to duplicate it exactly, you don't get the colors that you'd get as this impressionistic approach would be. See, there's a little bit of tinge of red in there. And maybe a little bit too heavy of a blue in there, but I'll warm it up with some nice blues in here. I'll put them in. I'm going to darken up the ankle here. This is in shadow, so it's going to be fairly dark. And underneath here is this very dark green. And that kind of shows up the slipper a little bit too. Okay, here we are again, and putting a little bit of blue in this lower area of the dress, a little bit of cerulean. Define a couple folds a little bit more. Let's get going and get rid of some of this more of this canvas here, and we're going to put some of the flesh color in. I'm going to add a little bit of red to this yellow ochre here, and put it in here and see how that looks. Not much too. little bit too dark. It's actually pretty fairly purple in that Okay, it's fairly purple, fairly dark right now, but we'll leave it for a while. That's okay. And come back again. And they add a little bit of this in here. There's a highlight on that skin on the outside, too. We'll worry about that later. And she's got her hand here. And it's not even drawn in here, so we're gonna have to draw that in. That's pretty difficult sometimes when you don't have it. It's not defined really. So. We'll just leave that there. I notice that this. This is supposed to be a little bit darker than that, so therefore this green should be just lightened up a little bit. Trying to cut in the hand. There's this backlit area. Some really nice soft greens back there. Let's try to get them in. And there's also some purples in that one. Some purples in there. Real nice soft ones. tinge of yellow in there. I'm just noticing that I pick out different things that just kind of pop off the top to me. I notice that I kind of have this flatter head. The head is flatter right there, and that darker green is coming down. And actually, it's helpful, I suppose, to have that that there. It's a much darker green than what I have here, so let's introduce some of those. And where is that? It's actually back here. Leaves stay off his head for some reason. Well, I'll tell you why. It's because you're seeing a reflection off of his hair. So we'll use some of that same idea. See that can really push this dark pretty good right there. You want to make sure you keep on grouping them. You don't want to get to look like a bunch of speckled. So that's something I got to watch out for myself now. Some still hanging on up here. Thank you. This is still darker over here. It's coming along. Been at it now, I don't know, 2 or 3 hours. So, probably three, I don't know. I don't keep track sometimes. So, that's the situation. Should still do some more work up here. No. Okay. Here I am again. I've been bothered by a lot of phone calls. It's bothering me a lot. So, all right, here I'm trying to put in these darks. Putting in some more of these darks in here. And, those darks you want to get dark enough. But don't, please don't use black. I haven't used black yet in this panel. Ultramarine blue. And green, blue, and burnt umber, right? Now, we've got a lot of stuff yet to do. This is just blocking it in, getting it together. Takes time. Don't let it worry you. Needed to be a little bit bluer there. Should always wear protective clothing because I've noticed that reds have a tendency of getting on your clothing a lot more than any other color. Just happens. See, for that yellow and that light, it was light enough to value is light, but it didn't look very bright. Why? Because it needed some darks by it. That really helps. See here with these greens over here. Got some. Hooray, here it is. It's probably pretty hard for you to see any kind of detail and so on. I worked a little bit on here and on the dress and so on. Just tidied up some areas, but now I'm going to work on the grass and just notice that it's not as light. Some areas. It's actually kind of dark down here. Before I had it too, possibly a little bit too more intense than it should have been. Pan out on this. Using a dry brush approach here. A little more yellow in this area right here. kind of texturize it a little bit. Going over that. This is sort of weird in that there is a kind of a right here, there's something's happening to the reflection and so on. Evidently, there's a reflection, a little bit of red in it, right in this area. Don't know what that is. But right here is the bouquet. And you can't see that very good. Put some more darks around it. And I'm twisting the brush here a little bit. Putting a little bit of blue in here too. Shadow some of these greens in here. Trying to keep the value still dark. Still dark. Value is not quite right yet. Uh-oh. Okay, there is a little bit of value change right in here. Got to put that in. You're like watching a coffee pot. Takes a lot of time sometimes. Something like this is not done in a couple hours. A lot of my larger ones can be done in 3 hours. Smaller ones done in about an hour and a half to two, easy. But when it comes to something with more intricacies like this, even though this is only 12 by 16, it can take a while. I want accuracy. I want the person to look like the right person. We haven't got him yet. I mean, there's going to be some work on these faces, like everything, yet, so I know that. Getting better, getting better. I don't, on these grasses, I look for still patches of lights and darks, and we're doing that. We're not painting every blade of grass. I just can't take that kind of stuff. I don't have that kind of patience. A bit more yellow right in here though. Right in there. It's lighter. Same here. It appears like now that's the that's the grass being hit by that light. See it there. Appears to be some darker blues right in here. Right underneath here. Probably put some in there. This dark right here is quite important, actually. Right there. Pull some of those greens back again and so on. I think there's a small amount of sky holes we could put in here. So with the sky holes, because this is so white here, this is made up of white and just a very little bit of cadmium yellow. And I'm putting it on fairly thick right in here. Now, the original has a lot of sky holes, oodles of sky holes in this thing. I'm gonna cut those back. Just too many of them. I'll put some in, but not so many. Not as many as what is on the original photo. Thousands of them. This possibly should be this purple here. Should be a little bit darker. As well as the darks way in a corner. Corners, typically, you know, to paint those a little bit darker is probably a good idea sometimes. So we hit a few of these up with ultramarine blue right in here. Right here. Up in this area. A little bit high. Bring it down to this same ultramarine blue, burnt umber, a little bit of sap green as well. We're just going to pull that down in here. Don't want to overdo it though. One thing about commission, when you're doing something from a photo, you're expected to do the photo. So what you're going to tell them that is going to look different than the photo, or you don't want to do it. If it's supposed to look identical to the photo, then it's sort of redundant to do it again. Mine looks a little bit more impressionistic. I still want it to look like a painting, not a photo. So hopefully we get that. I noticed that there is some a little bit lighter and a little bit yellower in this area right here. And we'll touch those up right here. These are getting really inundated with light. That's why they're so yellow in that area. Okay. I'm gonna make a few sky holes in here. Since I have a larger sky hole, make sure that you're, you know, around it, the edges and so on, appear like, you know, the edge should appear as though it's got leaves and so on. So the edges really mean a lot. I've said that so many times before. What you want to do is take these you do have to simplify. You do have to simplify. There, it's more attractive too. Because of the sun being so bright. And that permeates this whole area, but I have to watch it so it's not too different than the picture. The picture doesn't have that yellow in it and so on, but I feel it's necessary, so I'm putting it in, and that's, I guess, my prerogative. And I'm the artist, right? Just going to reinstate a couple of these. There. That looks a lot better. A lot better. I notice I have some dirtiness down here. I'm going to get rid of some of that as well. Especially in this area. Over this tree, notice this bush way in the background is purple. So I've painted it purple in there. Now this stuff, that looks like dirt, so we have to get rid of that. This is up a little bit high, so I'm going to take that down. That light's really hitting around here, so I'm going to make sure this is pretty light there. So, all right. So the background's coming along. Notice right here. Sometimes you have to get back from your paintings. Gotta have, this is not resting. I lost my line there. Had a hidden line, and really it's not. Where one, the mowed grass ended and the weeds and everything is, starts. There's a lot, there's more of a vertical one in this area, and I kind of like that, so I'm putting that in. They're coming along. I'm gonna put some grasses in here. I see some individual grasses. Just get a hint at a few of them. Allow the rest to what you want to do is if you have light darks, you want to cut in the light grass into the dark mass and the dark grass blades into the light masses. Hopefully you can figure that out, understand what I said. I'm doing the dark into the light masses now. Dark. And then light into the dark. And then I'm going to throw some dark in the lighter masses. Because even within the shadow areas, you have some detail can be seen. Okay, you don't want to make it too mechanical looking though. So I always cut through some of them and break it up. Don't want to look too mechanical. This is a shadow. The whole thing is in shadow area here. So I come back and forth, making sure my value is correct. Probably hit this grass up a few times, didn't I? This is darker, makes this look lighter then, doesn't it? Put a lot of ultramarine blue in here, mixed with some burnt umber. The darks still continue on around this area too. Shadow area is from the people, of course. Get those values right, and everything will make sense and it'll look right. I'm going to simplify a little bit here. I'm going to throw a little, some really thick white, actually out of the tube, mix it a little bit. Because it was a little bit too yellow, but still, I think it's effective doing it. What is that, a little bit more? Mixing it with the yellow white. Thank you. that looks better. Mix up a yellow green here and put it in here. Yeah, that's probably good. Probably have to work now on the face and so on a little bit more. Throw a little bit of this yellow green here and there. Won't overdo it. What you want to do in this grass is to vary your grass. It's got to different mixtures throughout. I really hope. Notice this is all one. Put a little bit of some texture here. Darken this up a little bit. Yeah, that was very helpful to do that. Maybe darken it up a little bit here. A little bit of yellow down here. As it's filtering underneath. there's a wee bit of yellow in this area right here, and I'm going to put some in. A little bit here too, a little bit darker. This is printed a lot darker than this should be. So this is a lot closer to the original image. I'm going to lighten this up a little under the top of the bodice here. A little bit up there. So